So it's about time that we cover some non-space stuff again. For example, the Tesla stock keeps on pumping. It looks more and more as if our prediction from almost 2 months ago will indeed come to pass as prophesied.
Then the Shanghai Gigafactory 3 is progressing further, with the first employees already starting by the end of July. Then BMW could see a revival of their EV efforts should Oliver Zipse really become new CEO. And finally, we got some real cyberpunk stuff coming. Elon Musk recently unveiled the first Neuralink brain-machine interface, and it completely blows our mind.
These news and more after the intro. On the 31st of May, we released a video where we said media manipulation, artificially printing a lot of fake news, that's fear, uncertainty and doubt, is keeping the Tesla stock undervalued. A lot of negative news were printed all the time. A giant anti-Tesla smearing campaign was taking place, making the stock decline from highs of around $380 at the end of 2018 to insane lows of just below $180 by the beginning of June this year.
We said that the stock is artificially undervalued and that it would certainly make an epic bounce again soon and go over $300 again. And of course, many trolls and Tesla bears were calling us blinded fanboys over on TradingView. Who is laughing now? The stock rebounded and is trading now at $258 at time of recording, and we indeed expect some continuing gains. First and foremost, because of the upcoming Q2 earnings call on the 24th of July. Because we think that Tesla will surprise many by announcing a net profit in quarter 2, which will of course boost the stock even more. It will be fun to watch all the shorters getting destroyed more and more, as Tesla will continue its climb over $400 within the next 1 or 2 years.
Now, a part of Tesla's future success will be their new Shanghai Gigafactory 3, which is almost finished. On the inside, there is still some work going on. The assembly lines are in the progress of being installed. The first assembly lines could start to produce Model 3s as early as in September.
But the first employees will start at the Gigafactory 3 by the end of July. This is crazy. I mean, just think of this. At the beginning of the year, there was just an empty field where the Gigafactory 3 is standing now. And now there are the first employees starting there in the next few days. That's an unprecedented pace. And in a new interview, we could already get a glimpse into the newly finished offices at the Gigafactory 3, and we could already see the first people working there.
At the same time, Tesla also did some publicity work by hosting some music parties together with QQ in certain large cities in China. They took place in Beijing, Shanghai, Guangzhou and Shenzhen from the 12th to the 20th of July. The more publicity, the better, in order to get the appetite of the Chinese for the new Model 3s going. And we think that due to the Gigafactory 3 and the general sales development, Tesla will be able to sell 400,000 vehicles this year. You heard it here first. Many say 360k, 380k, we say 400k. If you are wrong, we will conveniently never mention it again. Over at BMW here in Munich, it seems that in the last minute, BMW's supervisory board seems to be distancing itself again from Klaus Fröhlich as the new CEO, replacing Harald Krüger. Krüger recently announced that he would step down as CEO after his contract ends in May 2020. Harald Krüger is basically responsible for destroying the lead BMW had when they came out with the BMW i3 and i8 already in 2013, having quite some lead over the other competitors, aside from Tesla, of course. There was some talk that they would want to appoint Klaus Fröhlich as the successor, which in our opinion would have been an absolute disaster for BMW.
It would have been nothing less than the death sentence for this company. And I'm not even exaggerating, I really mean it. Because Klaus Fröhlich is known to be a die-hard anti-EV skeptic, saying things like, "The diesel engine has 20 more years and there is no demand for electric vehicles." Yeah, Klaus, right. That's why Tesla sales are doubling year over year since 10 years now. And that's why EV sales are growing exponentially all over the world. Because there's clearly no demand. Right, Klaus? But fortunately, the advisory board seems to have wisened up a bit and is now favoring Oliver Zipse over Klaus Fröhlich. And since Oliver Zipse is a proponent of electric vehicles, we could really see a renewed push towards electrification over at BMW. Should Zipse really hopefully get appointed as new CEO, because this is still not a done deal. But we hope yes, because it would be really awesome to see new cool electric cars really coming from BMW. And Munich is quite closely tied to BMW, so if BMW is not doing well, then Munich is also not doing well. And we wouldn't like the scenario very much where BMW is actually going bankrupt. And this would also mean that Munich will not become a second Detroit, which we would like very much since we live in Munich. So BMW, be smart, okay?
And now to the coolest piece of news. Even though it's not really electric car or transportation news related in any way. But we didn't know where to put this news. So we will just talk about it here. The announcement of the first Neuralink brain interface device, the N1. Now that's some real-world cyberpunk stuff going on, right there. On Tuesday, the 16th of July, at 11 p.m. Eastern Time, Elon gave a first presentation on what they were doing over at Neuralink. This company was always shrouded in mystery from the beginning, and up to this point, we didn't yet have any grasp on what they were really working on there. And now we finally know, and boy, is this some cool stuff! It's quite technical, and we don't have the time on this news episode to go into full detail. We'd have to do a full episode on Neuralink, which we actually might do in the future. But a simplified version is...
Neuralink is working on the first brain interface, the N1, which would allow you to control a device like a keyboard or a mouse or a smartphone with your thoughts. And the really amazing thing about this device is that it's not only write, but also read. So you don't only give information, but you receive information, meaning that you can download huge amounts of data from the internet directly into your brain, maybe solve some complex calculations in your mind, and just use this device to greatly increase your cognitive functions, making you even more intelligent and allowing you probably many more things that we cannot even imagine yet.
The benefits for paralyzed would be immense, allowing them to move again by restoring access to the motor cortex, the part of the brain responsible for movement, but also allowing blind people to see again. And in the long run, the end goal is nothing less than preventing the extinction of humanity by merging together with a super advanced AI.
Now, if AI should not be kept in check and grows rampantly, this is one of the technologies that has the potential to completely destroy humanity. But by merging with it, so basically becoming part of the AI, creating kind of a symbiosis, we absolutely reduce the risk of such an extinction event. This is why we are so fascinated by Elon Musk's endeavors, because we think they are a great filter prevention mechanism. The great filter taken as in the context of the Fermi paradox. So for those people interested into the nitty-gritty technical details about how you would implant it and how actually it exactly works in the brain, we put the link into the description. And the other cool thing about it, it doesn't come out in 5 or 10 or 15 years down the road, but no, this will actually come out by the end of next year.
So are you also impressed by the fast progress of the Gigafactory 3 in China?
I'm impressed. I have to admit, I'm really impressed.
I'm not. The Chinese always build very fast.
And what do you say to Neuralink? Are you as impressed as we are? I mean, that's some real cyberpunk stuff happening. Some cyberpunk 2077, like Matrix style stuff going on there. This is amazing.
Anyways, be sure to subscribe so that you won't miss any amazing updates from us for the field of electric cars, manned spaceflight, and many other amazing new tech.
See you next time. This is, by the way, my real voice. I'm speaking on purpose with a higher voice to sound friendlier. Ciao.